Hey, I'm Roberta from Email Tool Tester. Welcome to our Mailchimp versus AWeber comparison. Stay with me to find out which of these well-known providers comes out on top in this head-to-head. Let's dive straight in and take a look at ease of use. Mailchimp's design is clean and fairly easy to navigate. They're also pretty good at making sure you've completed all of the necessary steps when setting up your campaigns. AWeber loses a point here due to their slightly confusing navigation and naming conventions. For example, they call regular newsletters broadcast and they say campaigns when they mean automations. First round goes to Mailchimp. Having the flexibility to design your newsletter exactly how you want is paramount. That's why it's important to have a host of top quality templates at your fingertips, as well as the option to code your own in HTML, of course. Though AWeber offers almost double the templates of Mailchimp, the designs don't look half as good and they don't offer as much flexibility as Mailchimp. This round we're going for quality over quantity and therefore award Mailchimp with the point. Mailchimp has a number of options for setting up email automations. For example, you can launch a campaign for different subscriber groups, people interested in product A or product B, for instance. You can also create email chains. That said, editing the automations could definitely be made a little easier. Though AWeber offers slightly less features than Mailchimp, this does make them a little easier to set up. So, do you want power or ease of use? We thought each of the providers deserved a point here. Registration forms allow subscribers to add themselves to your mailing list. With Mailchimp, they're super easy to set up, and you can even add a field to help you better segment your audience from the get-go. One thing to be aware of is that setting up an embedded form, a pop-up, or a sign-up landing page has to all be done so separately and might cause you a bit of hassle when editing. AWeber's registration forms, on the other hand, are very powerful, offering you cool extras like the ability to add audio and video. But this does come at the cost of usability, and I'm afraid to say that the setup just isn't that intuitive. For this reason, we're giving the point to Mailchimp this round. Emails can look different depending on the inbox. It's therefore a good idea to test your designs before sending them out. Mailchimp allows you to do so, though you'll have to pay for it, and unfortunately they don't offer spam testing. AWeber doesn't offer either of these features, so the point definitely goes to Mailchimp here. When it comes to reporting, the Mailchimp Google Analytics integration works like a dream. You can track the performance of your messages across different geographical zones, track your e-commerce conversions, and you can even break down your deliverability stats by email provider. The clean interface makes it easy to digest and gain useful insights. AWeber's reports are on par with Mailchimp in terms of features, however, the design could be slightly more user-friendly. We're giving the point to Mailchimp this round. Deliverability, or rather making sure your emails arrive to your contacts' inbox, is maybe the most important factor when considering email marketing providers. So let's see how these two perform. Looking at the average results from all our rounds of testing, Mailchimp takes the point here. As you can see, AWeber has far too many emails end up in the spam folder, or worse still, go undelivered. Though Mailchimp has better results, they're still not as good as MailerLite or ActiveCampaign. Though Mailchimp offers a good knowledge base, their chat support is limited to business hours and only available for the first month if you're on the free plan. AWeber, on the other hand, offers support 7 days a week through multiple channels. Oh, and they're pretty fast. This one goes to AWeber. Unlike other services, Mailchimp offers a generous free plan and also the option to pay as you go. With a limit of 2,000 contacts, the free plan can only take you so far, and once you start paying, you'll see that Mailchimp can get rather pricey. Also, as of May 2019, new users and those switching from a free or a pay-as-you-go plan to a monthly plan will start getting charged per contact, as opposed to just the subscribed contacts, which was previously the case. Then again, AWeber's prices are no cheaper than Mailchimp's. Despite their slightly shady new pricing model, the fact that Mailchimp offers a free and a pay-as-you-go plan puts it slightly above AWeber here. Another point to Mailchimp. It's a clear landslide win for Mailchimp. In spite of AWeber having slightly better support than Mailchimp, AWeber really need to improve their overall user-friendliness of their service, and their deliverability rates could do with some improvement. With easier to set up automations and better reporting, Mailchimp beats AWeber hands down. But how would it fare against other email marketing software such as ActiveCampaign or MailerLite? Check out the article's link below. If you'd like more information on Mailchimp, AWeber, or any other email marketing tool, head over to Email Tool Tester, where we have tons of in-depth reviews. We hope you've enjoyed our video. If so, you can give us a like and subscribe to our channel. If you have any other questions or suggestions, please leave us a comment. Thank you for watching.